you know, and we are showing what you know is part of life. There are others that don't. There's others that love everybody, you know. But the good thing here is that at the end, she you know, she changes. You know, she becomes a good human being. She wasn't able to see a lot of things because she was a miserable human being because her husband made her feel, you know, although she never heard that before, I don't think, her husband made her feel not good, and she was into a drug addict, and she was an alcoholic, and so she hated everything, in fact. She hated life, she hated herself. Mm-hmm. She hated everything. She was not a happy person. And at the end, she changed.
Hola, buenas noches. Clary Castro de Intermedia. Primero que todo, felicidades por la película, porque creo que todos los temas que se tratan están sucediendo en la actualidad, sobre todo en este país. Las críticas que desde lo del racismo, la inclusión del tema gay, el hecho de que hayan tantas culturas adentro de la película, prácticamente es un mensaje hacia Donald Trump, hacia el gobierno que actualmente está en este país, y creo que es un buen mensaje, una buena representación de lo que hay ahora. Eso es evidente dentro de la película, así que no voy a preguntar sobre eso. Pero sí creo que es como muy válido consultar algo en el sentido de que todos los que forman parte de la producción son personas muy conocidas en sus países, son personas que son muy conocidas y muy respetadas en Latinoamérica. ¿Cómo fue para ustedes, más allá de lo del trabajo, fue divertido? ¿Cómo fue conocerse a nivel cultural, compartir y llevar su talento y lo que cada uno de ustedes representa para sus países en este trabajo?
Bueno, yo soy de España. Para mí fue algo increíble, porque estar en Estados Unidos trabajando en una producción americana haciendo de español, que aquí nunca, llevo tres años y medio y siempre tenía que hacer otros personajes, pues ha sido era algo totalmente distinto, ¿no? Y aparte me dieron la libertad de ser muy español. Y encima con Asunta Serna, que es la que hace mi tía, que fue profesora mía, además, de interpretación hace años. Y luego, yo creo que lo más bonito es ese contraste que hay entre las culturas, ¿no? Que se ven los distintos acentos, y hay un contraste que no sé, pues eso, lo que decía antes, que no se ha visto en otras producciones, ¿no? Yo creo que nos lo pasamos todo en bomba, incluso en los momentos que
sí,
dramáticos,
sí,
porque los actores nos gusta sufrir,
sí,
mucho. Pero yo personalmente, que siempre había querido hacer comedia, que nunca había hecho hasta ahora un personaje así más importante en cine y comedia, pues por la puerta grande con estos
señores. No, I would have said, if they would have told me, you know, that the movie is so, you know, messed up in the laboratory, we gotta shoot again, I would have said, when do we start? ¿Cuándo empezamos? Yeah, that's how much fun I had.
We had a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Pregunta aquí para el joven, ¿cuánto tiempo les tardó en realizar la película y en qué cine lo vamos a poder estar viendo?
Rodamos como por, no fue tanto tiempo, o sea,
cinco semanas.
Lo cierto es que aparte,
four weeks.
Yo iba a decir tres, pero porque también nos tocaban días salteados, que también es como es remarcable, porque la verdad es que hay producciones que son mucho más largas y, o sea, se ve esto en solo cuatro semanas.
Oh.
Y la verdad fue, ¿no?
¿Se van a ver en algunos cines seleccionados?
Yo no estoy al tanto de exactamente qué cines, pero sí las regiones.
Comenzamos en Los Ángeles, Houston, Phoenix y Miami. Serán los primeros cuatro ciudades y el marzo primero, y de ahí vamos poco a poco, expand to more cities.
Cool.
Yeah, and the song comes out February 1st.
Ya nomás.
Ah. Which it should have ended the movie with the song.
So you know,
in front of everybody. You know, right or wrong. With the up songs of the movie should end with an up song. Yeah.
What was the budget, can I ask? And how was the casting process?
It was under $10 million. What I'll say is, without getting myself in legal trouble, we really did this under the independent cinema kind of way of doing things. And this same movie could have cost 10 times more money if you did it the studio way. But we really wanted, and we've, you know, we don't feel like there's a whole lot of independent cinema going on, you know, in the Latino films. There are some, and we see more and more every day, and that's really exciting. But it was really important to us to take the same model that we've been doing with American films and put it to this film. So we really were able to put it together, getting all of our resources together and pulling a lot of favors, you know, and it was a labor of love and passion, and I think, you know, that's how you're able to pull something off like this. If you asked me to do it again, I don't know how I would do it.
yeah.
But Maria Conchita would be there.
Yeah, but Maria Conchita would be there.
Especially comedy in independent film.
And how was the casting process? Well, how did you get a hold of these people?
We had a
casting
director, and we started to kind of piece it together little by little. Mario Laneta and also Suad López Fil. And it was interesting. I mean, some of them we already knew their work, so it was, you know, we knew right away that it would be a good fit. And then some people self-tape, and some of them we were really floored. Fernanda Romero, who plays the daughter, did the scene where she, you know, tells her mom, "Where's my dad?" And Danny and I were watching it, and we almost started crying.
No, we cried.
Okay, we did cry. I wasn't gonna tell them. Anyway, and so, you know, we were like, done, that's perfect. And I also wanna throw a shout out to Guy, because his role was a very hard one to cast, because he opens and ends the film, and the entire time that you, in the middle, you have to feel his presence. You know, because the weight of his character, it puts a shadow over everything that happens. And I think all of us are thrilled that Guy was willing to play a dead body for half the film. you know, because I think what he brought to the table in his character created this shadow. He's in every frame of the film, you feel it.
Right.
You feel it on, you know, the pressure that he's applying on everything. And so we're very thankful.
But I think Bertha, the maid, stole the show. I think she's wonderful.
She did a fantastic job too, yes.
Yeah, fantastic.
Can I ask one more question?
Sure.
So